Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has referenced the fact that men and women are not the same. Allah says in the Quran, وَلَيْسَ ذَكَرُكَ الْأُنْثَى. The man is not like the woman. And our Prophet said, إِنَّمَا النِّسَاءُ شَقَائِقُ الرِّجَالِ. That women are the twin halves of men. They're complementary to men. They're not the same as men. And throughout the 60s and 70s, there was a movement that we all know now as the feminist movement. And this movement tried to portray men and women as being equal. Physiologically, psychologically, emotionally, they're all equal. But it failed miserably. Nowadays, a modern wave of feminism, a modern wave of research, is trying to go back and reclaim that damage, rethink through many of the issues that they had thought to change in the 60s and 70s. You cannot change the basic nature of men and women the way that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created them. And our Quran and Sunnah is full of the fact that men and women have different roles in society. It's not a matter of comparing the two. You do not compare apples and oranges. It's a matter that Allah created the man and He gave the man a role that is conducive for the man. And Allah created the woman and He gave a role that is conducive for the woman. And when the man acts like a man and the woman acts like a woman, family flourishes, society flourishes, children flourishes, and therefore the ummah will flourish. But when the man tries to become a woman, or the woman tries to become a man, they will never be able to change their fundamental nature. And so the man will fail, the woman will fail, the family will fail, society will fail, and the ummah will fail. So our religion is very simple and straightforward. وَلَيْسَ ذَكَرُكَ الْأُنْثَى. The man is not like the woman. So, what is it that a man wants from his wife? What is the primary emotion that he wants from his wife? Well, the primary emotion, according to modern psychologists, I'll bring in the Quran and Sunnah later. The primary emotion that men want from their wives is that of respect. That of respect. When a wife respects her husband, when a wife shows respect to her husband, the husband reciprocates that respect by giving the woman her primary need. And what is the need that the woman has? What is the primary need that a woman wants from her husband? What's the primary emotion? That is the continual love and the continual enveloping of that attention, that the husband always makes his wife his priority. The husband always shows his wife that I'm thinking about you, I'm caring about you, i.e. I will always love you. So, what does the man want? Respect. When he gets respect, what does he do? He gives what the wife wants. What does the wife want? To feel loved, to feel cherished, to feel always thought about, taken care of, that the priorities of the husband are the feelings of the wife. And when the husband is shown respect, he will reciprocate by giving his wife that love. And when the wife is loved, she will reciprocate by giving the husband the respect that he deserves. So I want to talk a little bit about these two emotions. What does it mean, respect and love? These are empty words until we translate them into realities. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, الرِّجَالُ قَوَّامُونَ عَلَى النِّسَاءِ. That men are قَوَّام over women. And قَوَّام means to be in charge of. This is the literal meaning of the Quran. قَوَّام means the one who will take care of the other. قَوَّام means the one who will be the one in charge. So what is the one in charge? The one who is shown respect. And we have that famous hadith, and no doubt this hadith is misused and abused, and we have to point this out as well. But it is the famous hadith that when once Mu'adh ibn Jabal came back from Syria, and he entered the masjid of the Prophet ﷺ, and he fell down in sajda in front of the Prophet ﷺ. And the Prophet ﷺ said to him, Ya Mu'adh, what are you doing? Who told you to prostrate to me? Why are you doing this? So Mu'adh ibn Jabal said, I returned from Syria. I found the people prostrating to their rabbis and their elders out of respect. And I felt you deserve this respect more than those priests and those rabbis. What did our Prophet say? It's a famous hadith. I should say it's an infamous hadith. All of you have heard of it. Verily Allah has forbidden any human to prostrate to another human. But if He were to have allowed this, if a concession were to have been made, there is no concession. If a concession were to have been made, I would have told the wife to prostrate to her husband out of what the respect and duty she owes to him. Now what is this prostration? It is the prostration of respect. The prostration of respect. And what does this show? That the wife gives respect to the husband. And what will the husband give back? The husband will give back that love, that cherishing, that nurturing that the wife craves.